Hello everybody, my name's Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a circuit that can be used to protect your more sensitive circuits from rapidly changing input signals. It's basically just a combination of an EFO clock down here and a T flip-flop, a piston T flip-flop design. Which makes this a really simple design. I wouldn't be surprised if someone else already made a tutorial about this circuit. So anyway, just a little demonstration. So as you can see, the T flip-flop part reacts once the signal strength, the signal gets turned off, and it only reacts when the EFO clock down here has completed a half cycle, so it only reacts once the items are completely transported into one of those hoppers and the other one is empty. So well, that's basically the main reason for this circuit. So okay, now as you can see, let's start with the space requirements. As you can see, it's 4 blocks high, 6 blocks wide, and 1 block deep, as you can see here. Okay, so now what resources will you need? Of course, you will need a few building blocks, then 4 redstone dust, 2 redstone torches and 2 comparators, 1 redstone block, 2 sticky pistons, 2 hoppers, and finally, some kind of input. In this case, I'm using a button. Okay, so now you know how much space you need and what resources you need. So let's start with the actual building. Okay, so first, place your 2 hoppers facing into each other like this. Then place 2 blocks on each side like this. Put your redstone comparators in those gaps, then some redstone on top of those blocks, finally 2 pistons facing into each other on top of the comparators, and in between a redstone block. Now put some items into those hoppers and we are done with our EFO clock. Pretty much the standard design. So now place 2 normal blocks on top of the spaces where the redstone block can be, put some redstone dust on top of those blocks, and finally on each end put a redstone torch, and now we are done. So down here we have our EFO clock part, and up here we have our T flip-flop. So all you have to do is power this redstone line here, for example with a button here, and you can toggle the T flip-flop. If you want to take an output from here, the easiest way is just putting some redstone next to this redstone block here. Okay, so that was how you can build a timed T flip-flop or anti-spam button circuit to protect your more sensitive circuits from rapidly changing input signals. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!